Our next guest grew up not quite sure if they were a boy, a girl, something in between, or all of the above. They've written a comedic memoir about the messy, complicated, often hilarious, sometimes devastating journey across the gender rainbow.
The book is called Sissy, a coming of gender story. We'd like to welcome writer, producer, and author Jacob Tobia.
Yes.
See, I got it right.
You got it right.
Good morning.
Welcome. Good to have you here. Talk about your childhood and your struggle with your gender identity.
Well, I always say that I didn't struggle too much with my gender identity. It was more that other people had no idea what to do with me. I mean, truly, as a kid, I had too much gender. You know what I mean? Yeah. My ideal day, I'd wanna like run around in the woods behind my house, get super muddy, like fight with sticks a little bit, come back in, you know, like bake a princess cake, play with a Barbie while I watch a science documentary. I just wanted it all.
Yeah.
And the world was like, you can only want half of that. And I was like, why would I only take half of that? That makes no sense to me.
And
so, yeah.
Well, because of that, you're saying to people, let's rethink maybe or not define gender in those traditional ways, because for you as a kid, you were going, why I don't fit into those boxes, if you will.
Right. I mean, I think that gender norms can be really harmful for everybody. You know, everyone's had a moment in our lives where, you know, something wasn't what boys were supposed to do, or something wasn't what girls were supposed to do, and we had to give up, you know, some part of ourselves or something that we liked, or had some moment of shame where someone shut us down or told us we were less than because we weren't conforming to the idea of what we should be. And so I envision a world where, you know, gender can be more expansive, right? Where you don't have to necessarily spend so much time worrying about if you're fitting into one box or the other, and you can kind of live in between or jump between them if you'd like, and just have fun with gender, you know?
The title of your book is a term, a word that can be very hurtful to people, sissy. Mm. Why did you use that?
Well, it's about reclaiming it. Mm-hmm. And it's also about honoring my childhood experience. You know, when I was a kid, I didn't have words or language to describe why I was different or how I understood myself. I just knew from what other people said that I was a sissy. And so in my adult life, I'm really trying to honor that inner child and think about who was I and what was my gender before the world intervened, right? Mm-hmm. Who was I sort of naturally and effervescently as a child? And how can I stay reconnected with that?
Yeah.
I also like sissy because it's sort of short, and I grew up in North Carolina, so it's sort of short for like sister a little bit. You know, it's like a term of endearment too.
I'm wondering how your parents were when you were growing up and how they reacted to the way that you were feeling. And I think there could be parents watching, and you know, you've heard this, you've seen a little boy that wants to play with a doll, and you know, mom or dad are like, no, you know, here's a truck.
Right.
Or what do you say to parents that maybe are uncomfortable with it, they don't know how to approach it when it comes to that with their own child?
Well, I don't want to pretend it's easy. I think a lot of who I was when I was a kid was kind of bewildering to my parents. Mm-hmm. You know, they had to spend many years catching up to sort of who I am today and figuring it out. I'm happy to say that both of them, you know, have really come around in a major way. And my mom's been supportive pretty much the whole time.
Yeah.
But when parents have young children who are gender nonconforming or who are just like curious, you know, who are just having fun, what I think is so important to emphasize is that yes, it may be difficult for if your kid, you know, is gender nonconforming, for them to go out into the world. They may experience some kind of bullying. They may face some adversity. But what I can always say confidently is that the only thing worse than being bullied in the outside world for who you are is also being bullied and stifled at home. Mm-hmm. You know, you have the opportunity as a parent to create a safe place for your kid and to ensure that your home is a place where everyone's affirmed and respected and treated with kindness and empathy. And I think that it's a beautiful gift to give your child that freedom and that kindness.
What do you want people to get out of your book?
I hope that they go in thinking, oh, I'm gonna read about Jacob, and then leave being like, oh no, what do I know about myself?
Yeah.
That's the goal. And I also hope that people laugh like a lot.
Okay. Once again, the book is called Sissy, A Coming of Gender Story. For more info, you could go to jacobtobia.com or follow on social media. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks for having
me. Appreciate you coming in.